Hey guys, welcome back to LSesh. Today we got a nice core workout in for you guys, so make sure you're warming up your wrists, your back, your ankles, and everything else that you need to warm up because we're gonna dive in. Before I get in trouble, this session is for you, Palmer, so let's get to it. All right, so we're gonna start on our backs. Raise to a hollow body. And from here, we're going to start pumping our arms. And every time that you pump your arms, make sure you exhale on the decline. So we're going to do 20 of these, okay? 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. To your left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. To your right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. To the front, hold. Know that I am. Make sure you're doing your core exercises that you're squeezing in your inner thighs. You don't want anybody to be able to pull them apart. So make sure you get into good habits early. 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower. Breathe in and breathe out. Take one more. Reach your arms over your head, bring your feet up, and then bring your shoulders up. So go for your toes. Reach for your toes. Ten more. Hold. Make sure your shoulders are off the ground. And start pumping again. Okay. Lower one leg. If you can, lower the right foot closer to the ground. Right leg up. Left leg up, right leg down, left leg down, left leg up, right leg up, left leg down, right leg down, right leg up, left leg up, right leg down, left leg down. Feet together, hold for 20 seconds. Hold it, you got this. I know it's burning. Burning me. 4, 3, 2, 1. Stretch it out. Big inhale. Big exhale. One more. Big inhale. Now, let's roll onto our stomachs. Have your hands flat, your toes tucked under. You want to squeeze through your thighs so your knees are coming off of the floor. And then you want to raise your arms up. Start bending them. Pulling it all the way back, trying to put your pinkies together. Bring them forward. Reach out like Superman. Squeeze your tush. Pull back. Like somebody's trying to pull you forward. Pull back. Get those pinkies as close together as you can. One more. Reach back, squeeze it, hold it. 3, 2, 1. Lower. Whew. It's burning. All right. Working your lower back is just as important as working your abs and your obliques. So, we're going to continue on with this, with these exercises, and we're going to go into locust. So, raise your legs, your feet, raise your arms, and reach out like Superman. Start swimming. Swim, swim, swimmy, swim, swim. Just keep swimming. Up the tabletop. From here, we're going to pull it up the plank. Pull it here. Make sure your shoulders are right over top of your hands. You're looking forward. Your butt is tucked under. You're pushing through your shoulders. No arch in that back. Hold. Down dog. Raise your left leg. Three-legged down dog. You want to pull that knee into your nose. Really arch through your back. Compress. And lower that left knee to your left wrist. Shoulders, compress into those abs and the core, and bring that knee to your nose. So we're gonna speed it up a little bit. And when you pull up, I want you to shoot out a nice sigh, like shh. So. Hold it for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower to chaturanga. 3, 2, 1. Untuck your toes. Spread your arms. And lower. Slowly roll up into a cobra. You want to think about pulling your shoulders up to your ears. Slowly rolling that hip back. Getting a nice stretch through your back. Stretching that core. Do one more of those. Roll up. Go a little bit further than last time. And let something go. Breathe. And lower back, child's pose. We're going to do the same, but on the opposite side now. So lower, or bring it up into tabletop. And then we're going to go straight back into our plank. And hold it here, push through those shoulders, tuck the bottom, engage that core for 10. Pushing up. One more. Start to rise. Pull the chest forward. Open up. Open up your heart. Picture your breathing. Lower back down. So left leg up, like we did prior to three-legged down dog. This time, bring that left knee to right wrist. As close to it as you can. And then push up and lower. And push and lower. Engage those obliques. Breathe. Exhale. The sounds help. Don't worry about sounding funny. Lower to chaturanga. 3, 2, 1. Up dog. Back to down dog. And back to plank. We have one more oblique stretch before we start to cool it down. Take your right leg. You want to bring it forward. Try to touch your toe to the front. And back, squeeze, 2, squeeze side core, 3, you got this, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, lower, back to child pose. The next side, I'm going to turn it around so I don't hit the wall. Okay. Take one more breath. I'm going to bring it back to plank. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hold it. 20 seconds here. Shoulders. Woo! Engage that core. Bring it down, chaturanga. All the way down. Stretch out to the Superman. Couple of inhales. Breathe. our backs. Try not to fall off your mat like me. We have one more power round to go, okay? You got this, you can do it. We're almost there. I see the finish line. All right. So, bring it back up into a hollow body fold. Your hands up, palms up to the sky. Start doing some scissors. Go up and down. Okay, lower. One more round to go. Two more exercises, 25 reps. Okay, bring your legs up into a slight straddle. Bring your arms together like you're pointing at somebody with your thumbs up. Lift up, lift your shoulders up, push through the center. Do a hollow body hold for 25 seconds. Palms up. And jab. Whew, we made it. Yes. We made it. All right. Want to be complete. We're going to stretch out our abs. So let's slowly bring it to a bridge. Bring your feet to your mat. Bring your arms underneath. Grab your hands together, push through your stomach, your shirt's not stuck like mine, there you go, push through your shoulders, through your abs, feel a nice stretch in your back, release your ab muscles, you put in a lot of work today, so this should feel good. Is in your pose. Let's do a wheel. So put your hands flat to the mat. If you'd like, you can roll with your head on the mat and then push up. Hold. Keep pushing through the shoulders. Bring your belly button to the ceiling. lower. Don't bring your bottom to the ground. One more up. If wheel is not in your practice, that's okay. Stay with bridge or cobra or anything that you feel a nice heart opener. And that stretches the ab muscles that we've really been working today. Feel free to do any other exercises that you'd like to pull down with. Some of my favorites be when you're laying on the ground. You want to take one knee, take your right knee up, bring it to the left side of your body, and make sure your gaze is to your right. So your body's facing the left and your gaze is to the right. You'll feel a nice stretch down the side. It actually helps lengthen your spine. Puts or recenters your spinal cord. Puts everything kind of back into place. And don't forget to do the other side. Twisting stretches should not be neglected. They really help with your spine, your alignment. And if you're like me, when you have bulging discs or just disc issues in general, it tends to feel really good. Pushing all of that back into place. Baby. Hopefully you're starting to cool down. You're not sweating nearly as much as we were. But you're feeling all the good benefits from putting in the work. Or you're screaming at me, either way. That's okay. Bring it out to a nice shavasana. More content to come, promise.